I think that women need to fight for what they are worth. And I do that in my sport BMX, meaning bicycle motocross. But first of all, I will introduce myself. I'm also 51 years old, and I live in the Netherlands. And I have a problem hearing, and therefore I need hearing aids. I am married over 30 years with Dries. Together we've raised 3 kids, 1 daughter and 2 sons. The son still lives at home, and I am proud to say that I am a grandmother of a girl of 3 years. My husband and I have another hobby, our 2 little lab doggies, 2 St. Bernards, and we have also our company in our Volvo business. This is what we do for daily living. It's all started as a hobby of my husband to restore classic Volvos and turn out to be a full-time job. 2 years ago, I diagnosed it with breast cancer. And after a long period of treatments, I can say now that I recovered from this horrible disease. I fought very hard and to get on my bike, and that's my passion, and that's also my power. And in 1982, my father has founded a BMX club with other enthusiastic people. And BMX was an upcoming sport at the time. And I really, really liked that sport. And I asked if I could try it, but my father didn't like this idea. He thought, and my little sister, who was more restless and much more aggressive, she had an aggressive character, was allowed to exercise it. So I was really jealous, you can imagine that. But after a long time of begging and complaining, my dad gave in and I could exercise the BMX sport. In September 1982, I started exercising, and so I was so happy with it, and I had so much fun. It was great to reach my goal to start BMX. I was very successful and qualified myself for the World Championship, but I was not allowed to travel alone because of my age. I was only 15 years old, and unfortunately, my dad passed away at that time. By working hard, I get my mom supported to continue my sport. This sport has the appearance of a children's sport, but nowadays it's a sport for grown-ups and adults. And for some reason, I quit at 16. And after a long break, I started again exercising when I turned 40 years. My purpose is to take away the prejudices of this sport, to motivate women to choose for themselves, follow their dream and to go for it. Unfortunately, there were just a few women in my age to participating in a competition at the BMX sport. Most of the women think it's a dangerous sport, which is partially correct. It's an extreme sport and with more chances for injuries, but with lots of training and right focus and concentration, for 99%, nothing happened. I failed many times too, but I got up and carried on, and it's just a part of the sport. Most important of it all, I think, even men can do this sport without exercising. People think it's an easy sport, but You must see the fear in their eyes when they start, when they hit the starting gate. Also, they are thinking, just a few little hills on the track. We cannot take it easily, but that's not true. You have to exercise it. Every child, every man, and every woman. And people think, I'm too old for this sport. But honest, I don't care what other people think. This is my power, and I'm proud to be the oldest woman and the only grandmother in this sport in the Netherlands. I have so much for the time being, and I do not quit the sport because people think I'm too old. Because there are a few very little women who join the BMX sport, I'm classified with men of 40 years and older. But that won't stop me from racing competitions. I think I can do that with a lot of fun, no matter how I finish in the race. Fun has to be the most important thing, and you have also feel comfortable with your sport. And people think I'll lose a competition against men. Couldn't be more wrong. Often people think women are less strong than men, but women can be stronger. But that's not my idea of a competition. I go for the best results, but making fun is more important to me. Meanwhile, my granddaughter loves the sport and very much, and we spend time together on the track, so you can see. I learned to fight for my dreams up to the present day. I found out at an age of 13, a teenage girl, that when you want something, you have to follow your dreams. I did it back then by begging my dad to allow me to for exercising the BMX sport. And now today I race competition on the track despite the prejudices. And even after 8 weeks, just after having my surgery for breast cancer, I participated in the next race. 9 months later, last year, 2019, I became second in the European Championship. Mm. Yes, I'm a go-getter and I don't give up. Now these days, I can't race because of the COVID-19 virus. Unfortunately, the whole world suffers with it, but I will not give up my dream that it's cycling. I started mountain biking, which gives me a lot of satisfaction, and I started cycling on my racing bike as well. So I take care of myself. I'm also very lucky to live in the Netherlands. I realize that the Netherlands is further developed than many other countries, and here are more chances for a woman to do what they want to do. It's less strange for a woman to do your own thing. I think a lot of countries can learn from that. Besides taking care of my family, I am also lucky because I received the support of my husband and my kids to do my own thing. They give me the freedom to participate in competitions and to train every week at the I train 3 times a week at the competitions. My husband is always there. What I would like to say to women and girls is that's very important to take care of herself. I think when you do something that you like, you'll be a better person, a better mother, a better wife, and a better employee. Besides my work, being a wife and a mother, I am me, and I choose for myself. So what I want to say, don't give up, girls and women, go for it and get the best out of yourself, and you're worth it. What I want to let you see is my helmet. I'm very glad with it. And you need to protect yourself by a body protector. I don't wear it right now. and you need wear gloves. So you're protected. You're protected by yourself, and woman has to take care of herself. I do it in my sport, and every woman has to go for their own thing. You have to talk with men. You have to get them support by taking them with you to the BMX track in my case, and let them see what's meaning for a training, a practicing. He can see I am happy with doing my thing. So I'm a good man. When he sees when his wife is happy, he is happy too. I can take him with me to my sport. I can talk about it at home. They see what I am doing when I'm training and practicing. So they can feel what I am doing, and they see what I am doing to get my results. They are seeing that I am happy. So he must think, men must think, it has to be something that is enjoyable. So they understand what I mean by having my own thing, and everyone is happy. I think that men, you have to involve them, to take them with you, so they can see what are you doing. I really, really like to give to say to a woman that no matter what other people said, you are worth. You are worth it to be yourself and what you do, and you have to get the best out of yourself. No one else will do that for you. And be strong, be proud, go for it.